flown to bits. Massive Grodd unguided rocket attacks are being launched on the city indiscriminately right now. Air and artillery bombardments as well. It's absolutely out of control. It is pandemic, ladies and gentlemen. I'll give you the news first on Y2K. The newest developments, a Pennsylvania nuclear plant has been shut down. One of the main systems transferring the power from it failed, but they say it's not a Y2K problem. And the things I'm experiencing here in Austin, Texas, the shelves are empty of water and some gas stations are running out of fuel. Here in Central Texas and in Minneapolis, Minnesota, the shortwave is basically down, ladies and gentlemen. Went off right as I went on the air. The big news on Y2K. Then we'll start going to your calls. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. All right, let's go ahead and get to this article. Associated Press, this came out at 7:22 a.m. Eastern Standard Time today, December 31st, 1999. Pennsylvania, nuclear plant shut down. One of the two nuclear reactors at PECO Energy Co.'s Limerick Generating Station has shut down this morning after a piece of equipment failed. Company spokesman Neil McDermott said the problem was not Y2K related. It was declared an unusual event, the least serious emergency classification of a nuclear power plant. They got to have a serious emergency to shut down a plant, ladies and gentlemen. You power one down, you're not going to power it up for at least days. It was declared an unusual event. At 2:55 a.m., shutdown occurred when an insulator on the main generator transformer from Limerick 2 failed. We had reports yesterday of this. Off the record, I would not report it, but I had it from a good source that this plant was having problem along with four other plants. I may just go ahead and report it here. What do we get good information here? This has been going on for days. From our information, it is not this transformer that they're talking about. They wouldn't just shut a plant down over that. Something serious may be going on there. So that the central government, known as the federal government, the occupational government in Washington, D.C., has set up a huge $50 million command bunker hooked into all the FEMA boxes that can take over all the shortwave broadcast and commercial AM and FM stations, as well as television broadcast stations. And we hope they do not activate that, ladies and gentlemen. Police and military are on high alert, running around looking for supposed boogeymen and terrorists under every rock. Military are highly visible now. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, there are trains of military equipment moving into Austin. Two nights ago, on Wednesday night, Fox News reported that the airport will be used as a massive holding facility for troublemakers or rioters here in Austin that has no history of riots. They need to get that country locked down so they can stage the election for Vladimir Putin. I mean, this guy is a demon. Have you seen this guy? It's just how he's raging with power. I'm Alex Jones. I'm your host. I'm just one of the great hosts here on the GCN Radio Network, and I've been very passionate today because I can't even keep track of all the developing news as it's coming in. I'm not even going to say it's 6 to 7 reactors across the country. I'm not even going to. It's bad, and I got this news about the Pennsylvania plant early yesterday, got it again off air. Confirmed it with someone that is 99% accurate, about like I am, trying to report the truth, and now I've got the Associated Press saying, well, they shut the whole plant down, but they call it an unusual event, the least serious emergency classification of a nuclear power plant. Well, it's got to be pretty bad for them to power a plant down.
Time is getting shorter until Y2K. If you want to be sure your family and loved ones weather the potential Y2K storm of delays, shortages, or interruptions of services, then now is the time to stock up on emergency supplies and a home food reserve.
As the developments move forward with this Y2K and this gear up for clamping down in America and Russia and around the world by globalist forces, we'll be bringing you the news as long as we're here on the air. Now pretty much dictator and controller of Russia publicly, and here in America they're gearing up and bracing for terrorism and militarizing everything in front of us. So it's happening there, it's happening here. There they're using the war with Chechnya. Here they're using Y2K and the threat of terrorism. Oh, this is extremely serious. 2 weeks ago, Topol M, 6,200-mile super range, multiple warhead, newest design, U.S. clone technology missiles were deployed across Russia. They're mobile. These are first-strike type systems. They're also designed to survive several strikes. from America or any other nation. They're deploying these, and Yeltsin openly has been threatening us weekly to nuke us. I mean, it's just getting insane. And absolutely, this looks like just one more ratchet on the takeover of America. And yes, they have an extreme strongman in, KGB leader, running Russia right now. They have deployed their missiles against us and their submarines, and have already delivered fully functional missile cruisers to China. Yes, he took the codes off, and he took away our first strike capability. By first strike, that means if missiles are in the air,
mm-hmm.
let's say 4,000 of them. Russians have got a lot more than that.
Right.
4,000 missiles coming in, subs launching, suitcases going off. We have to wait until we absorb the first strike. That will mean virtual annihilation to our military. Brass, I know you're CFR. You've been told you'll be able to be in the bunker if they go to this level. I don't know if they'll do it. It may just be ratcheting down the global system. All I know is this. Boris Yeltsin, at 4 o'clock in the morning, as the Russian time zone in its eastern area near Japan was entering into Y2K, he resigned, and now Vladimir Putin, known as Vladimir the Ruthless by the Russian people, is now taking the reins of power, supreme power in Russia, and he is a former KGB chief.
There's something else I want to tell you, Alex.
Well, hold on just a second.
Okay.
I mean, this is extremely serious. Again, I was getting this information, what you just said, 2 days ago, and I got it even more. I ignored it then I got it yesterday, and now it's in the Associated Press that in Pennsylvania, where you're calling from, in the city you're calling from, one of two nuclear reactors at PECO's Energy Co. Limerick Generating Station was shut down this morning after a piece of equipment failed. And they're saying it's non-Y2K related. This is just unbelievable.
One other thing. I heard Bo Greit say this morning that Russia said if their power goes out that they're going to blame us and they're going to set off their nuclear warheads.
Well, I didn't hear that, but I would be interested to have any details. Do you have the details of what Colonel Greit said?
No, that's all I heard him say was that they said if they had a power blackout, they'd blame it on us.
I know they're threatening to nuke us every single week. I've read the Associated Press, Reuters, Interfax News Agency, London Times articles here. I mean, I read Yeltsin and Jiang Zemin's quotes, the dictator of China, and they're saying, we'll nuke you. I mean, they spell it out. We will hit you with nuclear weapons. We reserve the right to hit you. 3 weeks ago, their head of their missile forces said, we reserve the right to nuke you first. Their currency is plunging. The Egyptian pound is plunging against the dollar, the Japanese yen, the Deutsche Mark, and the just all of it. It's and the same thing is starting to develop here in America. Many of the gas stations here in Austin have the little gloves over the pumps saying they're out of fuel. You've never see this in Austin, Texas. Right here in South Austin, I've seen several stations. We don't know if this is just a Y2K that was here. Just bizarre behavior. Americans standing up as Russia threatens to attack us with nuclear weapons, as nuclear power plants, at least one, are being shut down, as the military runs around with the police and the FBI saying terrorism is imminent, and some would characterize us as dangerous because we report the facts. Absolutely out of control. Just maintain your readiness, be calm, defend your family, defend your country. But doing a fabulous job. He is consulting with people that he knows personally, a lot of former military people that now own radio companies. And in fact, I'm not even going to say who the individual is. I'm sure he could call in publicly. I just don't want to give a lot of folks' names out on the air. They have activated a powerful Cold War radar system in the North Pole region. That is something that is drowning out shortwave. The entire 9400 band all throughout the 9.4000 up to 9.9. I mean, the military traffic is everywhere right now, ladies and gentlemen. Scrambled. We've got superpower radar systems, nuclear systems up.